Hi, this is Himanshi and this is Shubhi, and we are back with our daily dose of crypto intakes from Cryptonomics. Cryptonomics is the one-stop solution to all your latest crypto updates.
Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on the notification bell.
Rama Devi, a senior official in the ITNC department of the state government Telangana, has said that the new blockchain incubator would be pairing up with high educational institutes such as IIIT Hyderabad and the Indian School of Business. This would lend a helping hand to fresh startups in the working blockchain space. Liquid, the Japan-based digital asset exchange, has announced its partnership with Hummingbot, the institutional-grade crypto trading bot provider. To facilitate high-frequency crypto trading, Liquid has adopted fully integrated Hummingbot's solution.
Binance, the global cryptocurrency exchange, is launching a Zcash Tether perpetual contract with a maximum leverage of up to 50x. The announcement revealed that the trading of the new ZEC/USDT contract would be live from February 5, 2020.
An association of critical partners in aircraft maintenance, repair and overhaul industry has recently started to be uncertain whether aircraft parts could be tracked, traced or recorded using blockchain technology. According to PwC, MRO costs could be reduced to $3.5 billion worldwide using blockchain technology.
Bitspark is closing its door permanently on March 4, including the operations running in Hong Kong, Indonesia, Vietnam and the Philippines, announced George Harrop, Bitspark CEO and co-founder. Customers are free to withdraw their funds until March 4 and can also request withdrawals for further 90 days after the closing of the company.
Hackers have compromised 5 law firms of the USA and asked for 2 ransoms of 100 BTC from each company. First ransom for restoring access to the data and another one for deleting their copy rather than selling the data.
The government of Bermuda is considering blockchain and cryptocurrency adoption to enhance financial inclusion. The 60,000 residents island country have no access to mainstream payment applications such as Revolut, Square Cash and PayPal.
Indian think tank Niti Aayog released a draft discussion paper titled Blockchain, the India Strategy, highlighting the deployment of blockchain technology for the resolution of inefficiencies in businesses and governance processes. It focused upon the framework, necessities, challenges and regulatory infrastructure for the adoption of the latest technology.
The UK's Financial Conduct Authority has recently raised the registration fees it charges from crypto firms for registration. From now, FCA would reportedly run a two-tier system which would depend on the firm's income. Initially, the authority had proposed a fixed fee of £5,000 for all businesses.
Here are some other but important news from the crypto space. Petro continues to hit the Venezuelan vendors hard. OpenBricks blockchain-based property portal is live. USMS announced auctioning of confiscated Bitcoin recovered from criminals. Wazirex CEO opined that India should consider launching its own CBDC. China's blockchain development way ahead of others.
Top 5 crypto gainers of the day are EOS DAC with 177.54%, Dynamite with 100.10%, Trade Plus with 89.33%, Vega Wallet Token with 76.90%, Ibacus with 69.94%. Top 5 crypto losers of the day are Cash with -27.74%, Omnitude with -25.38%, Add Token with -24.55%, OnLexPa with -23.73%, Icon with -21.28%.
That's a wrap for today. Please don't forget to like and share our video if you love what we do.
Also, if you have any suggestions for us, please do write us in the comment section below. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.